Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon.
This is the Yukon in Arctic winter, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. Where the code of the trail greets every man as friend, and where sometimes the code is betrayed. Hungry Lake, off the trail between Dawson and Selkirk. Here one man had found the end of his golden rainbow.
All right, Chicklew. You'll get your turn.
What's that, Muskeg? Somebody coming?
Sergeant Preston. He'll be mighty glad to hear we struck it rich here, won't he, fella? And we'll rest a lot easier after he takes our dust into Dawson for us. That's not Preston. Wonder who'd be coming here.
Howdy.
We saw a side trail. Figured somebody was camping out here. Thought we could borrow some supplies.
Why, sure. Anything I got, you're welcome to.
Fine. We'll take it all.
What?
Seabee's got a gun, Ernie.
Just keep out of our way, old-timer, and you won't get hurt.
Here's a grub. Start lugging it to the sled, Ernie.
Look here! You can't do this! Oh.
I warned you, but you wouldn't listen.
You didn't have to slug the old geezer, Len.
He got my way. Here, take this.
Ernie, look. What do you know?
Pure dust. Must be worth $1,000 apiece, and there are five of them.
Yeah.
Come on, take the rest of that grub. We're clearing out. Get the old geezer's sled tarp, Ernie.
I don't like this, Bryce. Let's get out of here.
Do as you're told. I'll turn the team around and be quick about it.
No. No. Rob me, will you? Look out!
That'll take care of him.
Bryce, you shouldn't have.
What do you want to be next? That's better. Don't want to run into the Mounties before we clear out of here. Get moving, you huskies! Come on!
Chicklew! Husky!
On his regular patrol from Dawson to Selkirk, Sergeant Preston made a point of calling on the isolated miners who worked claims off the main trail. With the great dog Yukon King leading his team, Preston turned onto the branch trail toward Garfield and his happy hour diggings.
What's the matter? Who's that?
I don't know. We can't let him reach that shack.
Put up that gun, you fool. It's a Mountie.
Oh, yeah.
What do we do?
Let me do the talking. All right, you huskies. My name's Bryce. This is my partner, Ernie Stevens.
Sergeant Preston.
Glad to meet you, Sergeant. You heading to the happy hour?
Well, I usually pay Garfield a visit when I'm in the area.
You picked the wrong day, Sergeant. He's away.
Left a note he was going into town for supplies.
Well, in that case, I'll have to stop on my return trip. Where are you fellows headed?
Selkirk.
Well, I'm going to Selkirk myself. We may as well travel together. Take turns breaking trail, huh?
Yeah, might as well.
I'll turn my team around.
Come on, King.
Come on, boys.
What did you have to open your trap for? We could have gone the other way.
I didn't think.
That's the trouble with you. Now we gotta watch our step till we get rid of him.
I'll be careful, I promise.
All ready.
Lead the way, Sergeant!
Companionship along the trail is always a welcome thing. And so far, Preston's two new trail mates provided a welcome change from the loneliness of the long patrol to Selkirk. The weather was fine, and the trail took them through some of the most beautiful country in the Yukon. Several hours later, the two teams halted for rest and a bite to eat.
Our claim up Indian River didn't pan out. That's why we're heading back for another stake.
How long have you known old Jack?
Jack?
You mean Garfield? Oh, sure, knew him down Skagway. He's quite a character.
Yes, he is. Well, the water's boiling. I get the tea out of my sled.
King instinctively knew that something was wrong with the strangers who had joined Preston and him on the trail.
King, come here.
Listen, what's the idea of snooping through other people's property? You know that isn't right.
You saw that dog of Preston's nosing around our sled?
Don't be a fool. He can't smell gold. And if he could, he wouldn't know who it belonged to. Just act natural.
Yeah, this ought to warm us up.
That dratted dog, I'll show him.
Here, don't do that. Come here, King. Come here, boy. Well, you must snoop around other people's property. It's nice.
You bet, no harm. I'm just curious.
Well, let him get curious around somebody else's stuff. I don't like it. He's a vicious beast.
He's not vicious. Nothing to fear from King. He never attacks unless someone threatens us.
Well, who threatened you? With him around.
You fellas go ahead and eat. I'll take him for a walk. Come on, King.
I don't like this, Bryce. We gotta get rid of that Molly before he gets wise to us.
I'm thinking the same thing.
Bound to find out the old man has been shot. Preston is the only one who knows we were at his mine.
That's right. We've got to get rid of Preston.
But how?
You know that narrow ledge up ahead? When we get there, you fade away into the trees, see?
Yeah, then what?
Preston is going to have an accident.
But the dog?
If it's an accident, the dog won't jump me, will he?
Oh, by golly. Not if it's an accident. How are you going to work it?
Ready, men?
I'll tell you later. We'll lead. Our turn to break trail, Sergeant. On your asses.
Thank you.
As soon as we get around the curve, duck out of sight. I'll push the Mountie over the edge.
Watch it, Bryce. There's a narrow trail ahead.
Right, Sergeant. Sergeant, help! Stop your team! Help!
Ho, ho! What happened?
Stephen slipped and went over the edge, went out of sight under the snow.
Oh, no. Where?
Down there. Wait. I see something moving.
You see anything moving?
Down there. Underneath the overhang. See?
Preston, get this dog off of me! Trailing me with an accident! Get this dog off of me!
Back, King! Back!
Are you all right, Preston?
Yes. I don't think I can climb back up. My leg seems to be hurt. I don't see Stevens.
Hang on, I'll get help for both of you.
Oh, wait. There's a rescue rope attached to my sled. Throw it down.
Just hang on, Preston.
Wait, Bryce. There's a rope in my sled. Wait.
Where are you, Huskers?
It took Sergeant Preston a few minutes after Bryce disappeared to get over the shock of the fall. By that time, the two conspirators had rejoined and were speeding away from the scene, callous to the desperate situation in which they had left the sergeant.
Good boy, King. Don't try to come down. See if I can find Stevens.
Bryce had put on a good act in pretending Preston's fall was completely accidental.
There's no marks here. This is one of Bryce's tricks.
King! King! Get the rescue rope from the sled! The rope and the sled, boy. Come on, the rope and the sled. King! King! Get the rope from the sled, boy, the rope! Atta boy. Now drop it, come on, drop it. Come on, King, drop it. Drop it. Good. him, didn't we, old fella?
Thanks, King, old boy. It's a tough spot. Let's take out after those two and see why they tried to kill me. Well, maybe this is the reason. Hasn't been here long. Must have fallen off their sled. For a couple of fellas that said their claim didn't pan out, this is a mighty fat poke. Said they didn't even have a grub stake. Yet why would they lie to a policeman if they didn't earn this honestly? Maybe they stole it from old Jack. He came from his cabin when we met them.
Come on, Chief.
We ought to get moving, Bryce.
There's no hurry. Dogs need a rest, and so do we. Besides, what are you worried about? Nobody's following us.
Why take unnecessary chances?
Stop your whining. That Mountie's a goner, and you know it.
Keep your mind on something pleasant.
Like these little yellow babies. Yes, sir. This is going to make life easy for us. Hey.
What's the matter?
Come on, hand it over.
What are you talking about?
You know good and well what I'm talking about. There were five of those pokes and one of them's gone.
Gone?
Don't act so innocent. Hand over that poke before I slug you.
But I didn't take it.
You're lying. Now, where are you hiding it?
Now, look here. How do I know you didn't take it yourself?
Why, you...
You put on a pretty good act with that money back there. How do I know you're not pulling another one?
Now, look, you... I'm gonna choke that gold out of you. Now, where is it?
I haven't got it, Len, honest.
You're lying. Now, this is your last chance. Talk.
Don't shoot, Len. I haven't got the gold, so help me.
No, I guess you're telling the truth at that. You're too much of a coward to hold out with a gun at your head.
You sure that poke is missing?
Look for yourself.
It's gone, all right. You must have dropped it somewhere along the trail.
Could be at that. I was sure in an all-fired hurry to get away from that dog.
Well, that's tough luck.
Tough luck nothing. We're going back for it.
Len, the border's only a few miles ahead. Let's play it safe.
Don't be a fool. There was more than $1,000 worth of dust in that poke. Now, come on. Get the team turned around. Aye, aye, Huskies!
In their greed to recover every dollar of their ill-gotten gains, the two thieves raced back along the trail to the spot where they had consigned Sergeant Preston to almost certain death. They did not know that Preston had escaped from the chasm and that he had prepared a surprise for them. The missing gold poke was left as a decoy, not where Preston had found it, but farther down the trail in a spot better suited to his purpose.
Stop here for?
This is a spot where we left Preston. Let's turn around, Len. Have the team headed for the border. There's a couple of miles to the next part we can turn around.
Stop worrying. That Marty's dead.
All right, but I still don't like taking chances. We ought to be ready to take off.
Come on, come on.
Wait here.
What's the matter?
Look, the team is gone.
I don't like this, Len. Let's get out of here.
Get out my foot. We're going to get that gold. His team got tired of waiting and ran off, that's all.
I still don't like it.
Look, there it is.
Yeah. I still say something's wrong. Preston gone, his team gone.
Forget it. Go get the poke, Ernie. We'll be on our way.
Someone's coming, King. We're in luck. Our bait's working.
Drop that poke, Stevens. I'm arresting you in the name of the Crown. After him, King.
Get him off me! Get him off me! I give up!
All right, King. Hold up. Here. Come here. Come here, King. All right. On your feet, Stevens. You're under arrest. Where's your partner?
I left him back at camp. He was too smart to come back.
Yeah, well, that's a likely story. Turn around. Get going. Come on, King. Go after the criminal. Hold it, Stevens. Stay here, King. Put your hands up. All right, you can put your hands down. Get going. Right here, Stevens. Put your hands behind the tree. You know what's good for you. You won't attempt to warn your partner.
Don't worry. I won't.
Guard him, King. Stay.
Preston knew that with his injured leg, he was at a disadvantage. Since he couldn't take Bryce by assault, he would have to outmaneuver him.
Gun's empty. Drop it. You're under arrest.
Come and get it if you can, Marty.
Hold the name of the car. Bryce! It's just a flesh wound. On your feet. There were only five bullets in your gun. Where's the sixth? In Jack Garfield's body? We'll soon know. We're going to Garfield's cabin and learn the real truth about this. Let's move.
Man, that was a good first aid job you did on yourself, Jack. Get that wound from infecting.
Take more than a bullet to stop a tough old sourdough like me. Sure enough, didn't think I'd ever see these fellas again, though. I'll be thanking you to my dying day, Sergeant.
Well, don't forget King here, Jack. We both owe him a debt of gratitude.
Robbery and attempted murder. You strong enough to make the trip to Selkirk and file a complaint?
It'll be a pleasure.
Good. Well, King, that means we can say this case is closed.